Don't tell me, don't.
Well, come on after the national anthem.
paying respect to our colors as young Aiden Kern sings the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous flight o'er the ramparts we watched, where so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Hi, everybody, and welcome inside Independence Event Center, our national anthem by 5-year-old Aiden Kern. Alongside Jim Schwelb, Nick Vassos, tonight the 2-1 MISL Comets host the 4-0 Milwaukee Wave. Last meeting between these two teams, the Comets in their home opener, lost 23-21 to this Milwaukee Wave team. In that game, Ian Bennett with 5 goals and 11 points. The Comets had leads late in the game 2 times, but the Wave kept coming back and eventually won in overtime. As we turn to Jim Schwab, quick comments on that game in the home opener. The Comets had their chances, high-scoring game. It was crazy on the home opener.
Boy, they had 3 big leads, Nick, and they just gave them up. A lack of discipline, not getting back, and everybody wanted to score. This team has the talent to do a lot of things. They just have to have a little more discipline on the defensive side.
Tonight, the Comets are going to start Danny Waltman in goal, Vahid Asadpour, Brian Harris, Lucas Rodriguez, Leo Gibson, and Cody Andrews. What do you think are a couple of keys tonight for Missouri?
Well, I think they can get out like they did early. Get out early, but to show the discipline and keep everybody, not everybody back, but keep organized. Don't get stretched out. What a great game to call last game.
Yeah, it was exciting. And Keith Tozer, the winningest coach in indoor soccer history, brings in yet another undefeated team. And tonight, it'll be Nick Vordberg who starts in goal. Victor Quiros will play at one defender. Ian Bennett, who had that marvelous game last time, will also get a start, along with Luan Salas Oliveira, LSO as they call him in Milwaukee. Pablo and Nicholas Pereira round out the starters for Keith Tozer's Milwaukee Wave. What do you think about this club?
Very organized. The one word that Keith Tozer's teams, all the teams, U.S. futsal national teams, any coach that he's been part of, it's discipline. Organization, discipline, and he'll bring it. And it might be at different factors of the game, Nick, but like last time, they keep chipping away. Now, the momentum swing, the Missouri Comets have to stop that.
How about Milwaukee? You know, they're coming off a 12-10 victory over the Baltimore Blast, one of their rivals. And then earlier in the week, Milwaukee also went to Baltimore and shut out the Blast on their turf.
At home, that is incredible. In the Baltimore, I mean, Civic Arena is, and if that's what they call it anymore, but I should do my homework, but hard place to play, and they get a shutout, that's unheard of.
We're underway. Milwaukee is wearing all white. Comets are in their blue, trimmed in red. Cody Andrews tracks back towards Danny Waltman, the starting keeper for the Comets. Danny is 2-1 on the season. Here comes Cody Andrews, the KC kid. Down to the corner to Gibson. Gibson with a trio of white jerseys around him. Milwaukee comes out with it. Just underway here, live at Independence Event Center. We've had some tricky road conditions earlier this morning that caught several drivers off guard, and the winter weather is expected again later on this evening. So not as many here at Independence Event Center, but still a good crowd on hand.
Yeah, it's kind of a shame, Nick, that every time that you're played at home as a former player and a coach, you wanted a good weather, or at least decent weather, to get the fans here. And tonight, it's skeptical at best. So we wish, you know, everybody that traveled here all the best, and keep it between the lines.
That's right. And we'd like to say hello to the fans watching in Milwaukee. Here's Sosa for the Comets. Wall pose off the wall. Another drive by Gibson. Another one denied by the Wave. Good restart there by the Comets with several chances, but the Wave's defense held, and we've got a player shaking up on the field. It looks like it's maybe Marcella Fontana.
He looks a little wobbly, Nick.
He just keeps on going.
Yeah, but, I mean, he took one right in the chops. I mean, right in the nose and the face area, and it's wobbly. Anybody else would be out, but he's a tough veteran.
Here's Gibson of the Comets, back to the goal. Turns and faces the defender. Big pile up there just right of the goal. Gibson back up, still with the ball. Plays it back. Drive by Stokic, wide to the left. Comes off to Asadpour. Now back to Stefan Stokic, Comets defender. Swing it near side for John Sosa. John Sosa quietly having yet another productive year. Over to Brian Perez. Looking for Gibson in the middle. Whistle, and looks like we have a foul on the Comets.
Remember early on last game, Nick, against Milwaukee, every time somebody fell, there was a whistle. Tonight, one fall, one whistle. Let's see. And the key is the Comets look very aggressive. They're more aggressive than they came out last time. Let's see the results.
We've got our first line change in there. A couple of new players for the Wave. Meanwhile, Perez picks it up for the Comets on the half line. Missouri will go for a few changes. Danny Waltman's got it. Sosa goes off. Cody Andrews comes back on along with Brian Harris. Alex Megson is now into the game.
You've just been assaulted up in the booth.
I just got a nice. Whoa. Good thing we don't have a camera on us. There's Waltman way off his line. Heads it back to the center circle. And knocked out of bounds by Milwaukee. Comets will have it on the near touchline, 12:33 here in the opening quarter. No score between the Wave and Comets. Harris has taken 17 shots this year, more than any other player. Into the corner to Alvarez.
He looks different with the short hair, doesn't
he? He does. I didn't notice him. He also no fluorescent shoes out there. Byron Alvarez. Tonight's a night of giving here at the Comets, and once again, the community, the Comets fans have brought soccer balls for Byron's charity. We should see a bunch of soccer balls thrown out onto the field if Byron or any other Comet scores here in the first quarter. Here's Harris with a drive, and shazam! A three ball by Brian Harris. He just keeps on shooting, and here come the soccer balls.
Look at all the – oh, my – look at all the – Milwaukee guys are firing them back in.
Oh, that's awesome.
That is amazing. How many balls out there, Greek?
I don't know. 100. Here's a replay, Coach.
Look at this. He cranks it up from downtown. Oh, and it trickles in. I think the goalie had it, but he trickled in from, I mean, how far out was he?
Ogallala, Kansas.
Ogallala, Kansas. At least the Lawrence. I'd give you that much. It was at least the Lawrence. He hit it from, he paid the toll before he hit that ball. Pay the $1.45 and let's go.
Oh, I'm telling you. Comets off to a 3-0 lead, and again, that's from 55 feet away, Brian Harris, a three-point goal for the Comets. For Harris, that's his third goal on the year. He now has 8 points on the season and continues to be an offensive threat from the back line. Thanks to all the Comets fans who brought the soccer balls out here. Those soccer balls are going to be gathered up, and they will be shipped down to Byron Alvarez's hometown of Mexico City, Mexico, and they will be distributed to children who don't have an opportunity to have a ball. So thank you, soccer fans, for stepping up tonight. That's going to help a lot of kids play some soccer.
And that's the, you know, this is the time of year to give. You know, we give to our families. Everybody gives gifts, but to see all those balls there, Nick, that's pretty cool. I mean,
as a player, you're yeah. like, oh, man.
And you know what?
On.
When you're on the road, Milwaukee fired some back. I don't blame them. It's like the home run in baseball. They throw it back on the road. I mean, they were like, hey, somebody's bombarding me with balls.
Come on, man.
They should have read the game notes.
That's right. It was in the script.
We got more action up in the booth, too. We've been handled, kissed. Yes. Former coaches, former players. I mean, it's been, tell you what, if there's an assault charge, it would have been charged in the booth.
Oh, I'm telling you, man. We're not paying you enough.
Hands on. That's what it's all about, though, Greek. That's what it's all about.
All right, under 12 to play, and right now the Comets with 3 points. Listen to this stat, Jimmy. Nick Forberg, here's his stat line. 3 games, he's 3-0. And his points against average is a microscopic 4.67.
Yeah, that's in this league, and in this game, it's sick because there's so many different chances, opportunities. It's indoor pinball. That's what it is, soccer pinball.
It's crazy is what it is. Here's Rodriguez with a drive. That one deflected wide.
My prediction, he'll have that at first quarter.
Yeah, Comet's just a 1 point away from eclipsing his points against average. With 1 goal by Brian Harris. As we look now at John Sosa, his pleas have gone unanswered by the officials.
They usually do. You keep asking. It's like at home. We keep asking. We're not getting anything.
Here come the Comets. Here's Sosa down to Gibson. Gibson rolls it in. Forberg covers it up. And the Wave will come back the other way. Hey, Comets fans, let us know what you think about tonight's match. Tweet us your thoughts with the hashtag #BeatTheWave. You can see your tweet up on the boards around the Independence Event Center. MISL Comets, at MISL Comets. Here's Gibson with a drive and that one wide to the right.
That was sponsored by Yo-Yo. He pulled it back and forth a couple times.
Oh, here's Gibson again. Got space. A drive. Oh, Forberg got a piece of that one. Asadpour was off the mark on the rebound shot. Here comes Milwaukee. Giuliano Oliviero here. He's been around this game for a long time.
He was playing when I played.
Yeah, he was playing up in Montreal. Played for the Edmonton Drillers at one point.
And like last game, Oliveira, he played very well, and he's always composed. And he'll finish his chances, too. You just got to make sure you put a body on him.
Keep an eye on him. Here's Judson McKinney. He's a strong young player for this Wave team. He's appeared in all 4 games for Keith Tozer's Wave. Comets on the restart. Cross the half line to Gibson. Forward to Perez. Brian's got a pair of goals on the season. Double teamed in the corner. McKinney comes up with it for the Wave. Over to Forberg, tries to clear it. Harris got a piece of it. And what do we got? A foul probably called on Milwaukee.
When you go that fast into the boards, something's going to happen. Woo! Whether it's good, bad, or ugly, that was a little, you know what? I think it was a good call.
Comets will restart it. Here's Asadpour, forward to Gibson. Leo's had several good chances early. Leaves it back for Cody Andrews. Rolls it to Perez, poked away from behind. And the Wave will come up with it. Marcio Liete down the right side. Liete trying to cross it over to Fontana, broken up by the Comets. Touched by Asadpour to the center circle. The Wave will control with 9:19 on the clock. Front and center, Liete. Thought about the left foot. Gives it to Pereira. Rolls it in. Easy save, Waltman.
Nick, what we got to watch out for, like last game that hurt the Missouri Comets, the transition game, they got caught with numbers down several times. They got punished a few times, and it really hurt the momentum of the game.
One thing we talked about in the last game between these two teams was how Milwaukee pressured the Comets, or didn't. At times it seemed Milwaukee would high pressure, and then other times it seemed as if they sat back to draw the Comets out and
they're
try
doing
to
the
counter
same,
them.
That's the same thing. Coach Tozier does not want you to get any kind of similarity repetition. He'll change it up. He'll usually go 6-7 minutes and then go high pressure so the defenders don't get comfortable on the ball.
Here comes Milwaukee, a foul on the Comets in the midfield area. That's going to go against Alex Megson. That's his first. 3-0 Comets on a goal by Brian Harris, a three-pointer. Fabinho. A kick back to Pablo. Correction, Montana. Fontana. I'll get it right one of these days. Here's Fabinho, lifts one into the corner and headed in there by J.C. Banks. Banks was there on the header.
Banks played well last game, Nick. He was very much of a factor during the game and the win for Milwaukee.
Here's Stefan Saint-Louis in the Comets' last victory. Got the game-winning goal in overtime against the ambush drive by Sosa. Was blocked by the Wave. Another drive. That one by Palmer goes wide. Now out front. A shot. Oh, Milan Ivanovic missed the bunny. Still trying to dig it out of the corner. Sosa's there. Will the Comets get another chance at it? Still pinballing around. Cleared away by the Wave.
He did everything well there. Took it down, cut it, and then missed the sitter, but what good action so far here from Missouri Comets.
Here's Saint-Louis. A juke and a jive. Rolled over the top of it. Now Rodriguez tries to swipe one in there along with Ivanovic. Robert Palmer's in there as well. Now lifted towards the Comets end. Bumped from behind by Sosa to foul. Sosa takes down Carlos Munoz, who's been a great addition to this Milwaukee Wave team.
Nick, we are 4-for-4. Four falls, four whistles.
We'll keep track of that. Keep track of that one, Coach.
Are we supposed to say that?
Yeah. No.
Oh.
No,
okay.
I mean, it's an observation.
Just an observation.
We have an observation deck right here.
And let me tell you something. It's hard to even play the game, but the referees are always harder because you have so many critics up in the stands.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm not criticizing. I'm just making an observation, like you said.
Hey, it's hard enough to try to keep track of the game with score and notes and all the stuff that I do up here, because if you look down, I can't tell you how many times I've looked down, writing something down, and something happens on the field and I miss it. It's that fast.
Well, that's why you make me look good up here. So, you know, you keep doing what you're doing and we'll keep plugging along, my friend.
All right. Hey, once again, Comets fans, let us know what you think about tonight's game. Tweet us your thoughts at hashtag BeatTheWave. The Comets handle is at MISL Comets, or you can tweet at MISL. Let us know where you're watching. Let us know, are you watching the Comets? Are you in Milwaukee watching your hometown team, the Wave? Maybe you're in another MISL city. Let us know. Where you're watching from, we'd love to hear you.
Great fans in Milwaukee, have good friends up there. Michael King, Jimmy Banks, now he has a son playing. You know you're getting old, okay? Or you are old when you see the players that you played with, their kids playing. So you know that's, we're ancient up here. Not you, but.
I don't see a gray hair on your head, Schwabi. Not one.
You know what? That's a good stylist. Billy.
You look good at your advanced age.
Thank you, Greg, but you're blind, so that's
usually
okay.
You say I know.
I know, but.
You know. 6.5 to play in the first quarter. 3-0 Comets in the left wing corner. Still pinballing around. There's a toe poke there from, I think, Brian Perez. Vortberg's got it for the Wave.
Brian Perez so far has played a more active role than he did the first game we watched.
Oliveira on over to Quiros, Victor Quiros, another veteran fine defender for the Wave. Victor will lift it across the line over to Ian Bennett. Can't get the hop off the wall. Comets touch it to the center circle. Ossetpour with a touch. Now Gibson pinballs back to the Wave. Here's Ian Bennett. Back to Ian with a long drive from three. Ed Waltman makes the save. Remember, Ian Bennett scored 5 goals against the Comets back on November 16th when the Wave beat the Missouri Comets 23-21 in overtime. Bennett, 5 goals and 11 points that night. He's had 5 points since. And we're coming up on the 5-minute mark here in the opening quarter. Here's the team captain, Ossetpour, forward to Alvarez. Byron, a scoring machine, over to Perez now, left wing. Brian front and center for Byron. Now Stefan Stokic. Touch near side, Sosa. Here's Stefan. Over to John Sosa, right side, Ossetpour. Ossetpour for three, and Vordberg makes the save.
You know what I'd like to see there, because Vordberg is so good and very solid. You got to get traffic in front of Vordberg. When Vahid's starting to hit it, you got to start running some traffic in there. See the Comets run across the box. Deflections and or distractions. It's very key in indoor soccer. These keepers are too good if it's straight on.
Similar way that Brian Harris scored that goal with some traffic in front of Vordberg, that three-pointer that's given the Comets this lead right now early on. Here's Nicholas Pereira. Plays it out forward, and here come the Wave. Down the right side, they'll back it up to the half line. Alvarez steps in to win the ball. Here's Byron across the half line. All kinds of traffic around him now. Leaves it for Megson. He'll pop it at the other end, and it's a bit too strong. Goal kick coming up for Milwaukee.
I don't mind seeing that for Alex, because a lot of times before in future games they try to cut the ball back and force something in the back, and all of a sudden it gets cut out and they got numbers against. There, you know what, he didn't take any chances, played it forward, and yeah, it's not, you know what, it's not what you desire, but it's the smart play.
Here's Nicholas Pereira operating front and center, marked by 2 Comet players, leaves it for Marcio Liete. Liete through a couple of blue jerseys. Comets come up with it. Ramon Palmer there on the field. Wave recapture it. Pereira goes off and Everton comes back on. Interesting note about Everton. He's an experienced player, but he doesn't have a goal or an assist so far this season. Is that amazing? That surprises me.
Yeah, for how busy is it, he is and a skilled player, it just doesn't happen.
Thought Ivanovic might have had a chance there, but bounced
back
up.
Don't say it. If that's the case, you know, usually we said it was going to be a blow away. I mean, they're going to blow them away last time, and they came back and won. So I bet Everton scores tonight. Let's call Vegas right now.
He's got 10 shots on goal, no points. He's played in 4 games. That's just a bit surprising.
You know what? I say he gets the point tonight for the Christmas stocking.
Crossed over to Everton. Comets are there. Cross the line to Leo Gibson. Here's Leo. A drive, and that one off the near boards. Comes off to Perez, who fires it in there. That one blocked straight up into the air. It lands on the carpet, and Bennett is there for the Wave. Ooh, crossed into the middle. Dangerous there by Pablo. That one poked into the referee's bin by Brian Harris of the Comets. Wave will have it. There's a drive, and that one off the near ball. Oh, Danny Waltman.
Yes.
Just smooched the post right there.
The keeper's best friend. And that thing came out almost to the yellow line on a rebound. He hit it well. Watch this.
Oh, there's Vordberg with another save. Under 2 minutes to play, another drive, and Vordberg is there. We're going to read some of your tweets coming up here when we start out the second quarter. So keep them coming. At MISL Comments and use the hashtag #BeatTheWave.
Nick, 12, 15 years ago when we first did the broadcast on television. If you said, let's tweet something, what would you think? I mean, what you'd be like?
I would have said, stop talking.
Time out. You'd be like, is the bird coming up in the booth or something? What tweet? Now all of a sudden it's that.
What are you talking about?
Tweet what? Tweet.
Excuse me? What did you say?
That is, you know what, technology is amazing, and everybody's buying on, though. I mean, you look at, everybody's tweeting. You got LeBron tweeting, Dwayne Wade, and Kobe. Nick Vasso's tweets on Fox 4.
Ashley Curlis says, let's hit them like a tsunami. Beat the wave.
Ooh, that is creative. Huh? Very
and
nice.
Chris Stockwoods says, we love the Comets cheerleaders. Let's go. One minute to play in the first quarter. 1 minute.
1 minute left in the first quarter. 1 minute.
Ryan Perez, Asadpour, Sosa, Gibson, and Robert. Correction. Yeah, Robert Palmer's out there. Here comes the wave across the line. 30 seconds left. Here's Oliveira in the middle to Banks. Correction. That was Tony Walls. Waltman up with it. Throws to Perez. 23 seconds on the clock. Perez running to the boards by Pereira. A whistle and a foul.
5 for 7. That's okay. Well, I tell you what, but you got to watch the discipline here. The diving in with the Comets. Early, I mean, here on the last break, on the transition, they survived it. But then going back, they're on transition. Milwaukee survived it going back. They got to keep the discipline going. No diving in. Keep it simple. Let them earn their goals tonight.
Here's Cody Andrews. Cody with a left footer blocked by the wave. Harris will settle it for the Comets over to Waltman. 7 seconds on the first quarter clock. Harris for three. Ding dong. Oh, Margaret. He hit the crossbar. Oh, and then Gibson with a drive hit the buzzer.
That was sponsored by Trek Bicycles there. What did Brian Harris, like, what do you have his pregame meal? He hit a cannon.
I'm telling you. Here it is again. Look at this.
Look at this. He hit it from, I mean. Oh.
And then Gibson was there. As time expired, tried to go volley. A horn sounds, and that's it for the first quarter.
That looked like it hurt when Leo came up there. It didn't look like it hurt him. It hurt up us in the booth.
Woo!
Oh, we're sponsored by the my goodness.
Advil. We'll take a break. Second quarter action is straight ahead. The Comets lead the wave 3-0. We'll be right back.
Come on, make some noise. There we go. Now I'm with my new best friend, Jan, here. Jan's going to be helping us out with the Shocking Prices High-Low game. Their brand new location, 291 and 23rd Street. Calvin, make sure you stay out of the way right here. But what we've got is we're going to tell you the item that they're playing right over there or that they're fighting over is a deluxe poker game. It retails for $29.99. If you walked into Shocking Prices today, I'm going to tell you it's $3.99. So you have to decide, Jan, is it higher or lower than $3.99? What do you think? Help her out, guys. Come on. Higher or lower? Take your time.
I think it's higher.
She thinks it's higher. It's actually lower. It's only $2.99, but we're still going to get you a gift card to Shocking Prices. their new location, 291 and 23rd Street. So close. And now you get a sweaty hug with his sunglasses. Ed, back to you.
And the second quarter is underway here live at Independence Event Center. The 2-1 Missouri Comets hosting the 4-0 Milwaukee Wave Comets with an early 3-0 lead on a three-pointer by Brian Harris. We've been asking you tonight to tell us what you think about tonight's match on Twitter. Use the hashtag #BeatTheWave. Tweet us at MISL Comets or at MISL. And we've got Rich Pichetti listening, and he says, long live the Canton Invaders. He's listening in Ohio, and a special hello to Rich Pichetti. Good to hear from you, my friend. Paul Arndorfer says, let's go, Comets. And we also have Jeff Upton that says, when did Dr. Phil start coaching the Wave? Jeff, he's talking about Keith Tozer.
I see a similarity.
He's got there. So many victories, he should be a doctor. He's a winningest. He's won, like, what, 1,500 games over his career, Swabby?
Too many games that I can count.
He's got another undefeated squad tonight. Here's Everton. Right side crossed. Comets are there. That was Robert Palmer up to Gibson. Now Pablo will touch it back to Vordberg in front of us. Nick Vordberg, 3-0 on the season. Marcel Feenstra started the game back in November here at Independence Event Center. Feenstra got the victory, but again, the Comets scored 21 that night. And Vordberg has just been remarkable. Perfect 3-0, and again, his points against average microscopic at 4.67. 13:25 left to play in the second quarter. Here's Ian Bennett, splits the defense, hits the carpet, needs a little roadside assistance, and a foul called on the Comets.
Triple A service tonight. He got hammered there. Good call by... Brian Martin doing the referee job tonight, a local Kansas City referee.
Here's Ribeiro. Wall pass broken up by the Comets. Gibson is there. He settles it, plays it forward for Milan. Ivanovic in the area, pokes it up to Perez, try to volley it in. Sosa in the area as well. See if the Comets can hang on. They do. Here's Gibson. Try to slide it through a couple of defenders. Rejected back to Cody Andrews of the Comets. The KC kid. Now Asadpour. Forward to San Luis. Oh, San Luis with a toe poke. That thing came off quick. Here's Ribeiro trying to clear it. Held in by Perez. Now San Luis tries to dig it out of the boards. Whistle and a foul. That's going to go against Milwaukee.
Milwaukee fouls on the break for Fabio.
Yeah,
Ribeiro. That's
Fabio Ribeiro. So the Comets will get a free kick here just outside the three-point arc on the right wing. Here's Asadpour behind the ball. Calls over Harris. Now Asadpour will take it. Brian Harris shows up, and it goes in! Comets goal! The Comets and Vordberg is shaken up. Brian Harris scores again, his second on the night to give the Comets a 5-0 lead, but looks like Vordberg's going to be okay, Schwabe.
Yeah, I think so. He stuck his hand out. I don't think he had possession of the ball. Brian Harris watched the ball off the boards, and all of a sudden, Brian Harris collision with Vordberg. One thing, the ball off the boards is what beat the Comets last time. Remember the set piece off the boards. So, you know, turnaround, you know, kind of fair play in this business. Nice set piece drawn up by the Comets.
.234 of the second quarter. Harris scores his second on the night. And for Brian Harris, that's his fourth goal on the season. And he now has 10 points overall on the year. Brian Harris having a great night so far. And the Comets, by the way, have outshot the Wave 11-2. Kind of syncs up with the eye test as far as what we've seen here tonight. A lot of chances by the Comets.
St. Louis played well. He's got to keep his balance here. He's tripped a couple of times coming out of the gate here late. They got to calm down. Remember, Nick, last time we're up. We got 4 or 5, 6-point lead. Bad penalties, lack of discipline, not getting back on time in transition. Killed Missouri Comets last time. Destroyed the momentum of the game and also got Milwaukee back in the game. Let's see if they can stay on top tonight. And on Milwaukee's behalf, they chipped away. They did what they needed to do. And you know what? Obviously won the game on the road. Anytime you can win the game on the road in this league, it says a lot to your coach and your players.
Milwaukee's experienced. They're strong. And they've been battle-tested. Here's Luan Oliveira. And Andrews steps in, nearly wins the ball. Now a drive for three, and Waltman swats it high. Pereira trying to settle it. Now Fontana in the corner. Fontana leaves it back. Here's another drive for three. I think Waltman got a piece of that one off Victor Quiros. Here's Quiros again. Got some space. To the far post to Everton. Popped straight up into the air by the Comets.
Cody Andrews did well to get to that ball. That ball was going directly to the back post for a tap-in.
10.5 to play in the first half. Here's Quiros. Cross the line. Now back to Victor. Now it comes near side to Tony Walls. Walls pass picked off by the Comets. Alex Megson gets it up to Milan. Milan popped it forward for Gibson, but taken back by, no, still fought for. Fontana's got it now. Oh, Fontana tripped up and look out. John Sosa got tangled up with Marcelo Fontana, and Sosa called for the foul. Fontana's the captain tonight. He's got 2 goals and an assist, 5 points for the veteran, Marcelo Fontana.
That was a little questionable on that call. He got him good there. You got to watch the discipline of the tackles coming in.
That went off the glass. Everton is there, blocked by a pair of blue jerseys. Now Banks gets it back to the far post, kicked out by Andrews, and then up and over the glass it goes.
Somebody's getting a bill in the mail.
Hey, Nick, they knocked the scoreboard loose there.
Oh,
up top.
A panel came off of the scoreboard.
Please keep your eye out up there underneath that sign. We believe it's attached. Please keep your eye out in case I'm going to come down. If you are underneath,
hey, we've been asking you to let us know what you think on Twitter tonight about tonight's game by using the hashtag #BeatTheWave or tweet us at @MISLComets. And we've got a tweet here from our old partner Art Kramer, Schwabe. He says, enjoying the webcast, fellas. Enjoying the 7-step rule. 7 steps from my big screen and my refrigerator. Hashtag Michelob.
That's a good old St. Louis boy there.
I knew Artie Kramer was on the – I don't know if Tom Wynn's on Twitter or not. Tom seems to be kind of a texting kind of a guy. He may not be on Twitter, but I gotta be sure to save that handle from Art Kramer. I want to follow him.
He's yeah, I'd like to follow him too. You know what? What a great class act. What an unbelievable player and ambassador to the game and good in the booth as well.
Yeah, I'll tell you, I was employing the 7-step rule when Milwaukee was playing Baltimore the other night. I was listening to you guys. Under 9 to play here in the first half. Vordberg's got it for the Wave.
Art, don't forget to send our Christmas presents. We are waiting.
Ah, I'm glad you reminded him.
Yes.
Into the corner it goes. Pereira is there, surrounded by a pair of Comet defenders. They kick it out towards the yellow line. Gibson goes down. Poked forward by Ribeiro, all the way back to Vordberg.
Remember a couple years ago, the defender Leo Gibson all of a sudden moved up to forward and he scored all these points?
Yeah.
Brian Harris might be getting, look at him. He doesn't even know how to spell defense anymore. He's just pushing up.
Brian Harris, I'm sure he would tell you he's playing out of position. He should be playing up top.
No defender thinks, when they're scoring, they think they're a forward. Let me tell you something. If you're scoring, hey, the forwards can't do it. Let me do it.
Here's Ian Bennett. Floats one for Nicholas Pereira. Oh, he let it roll through the 5-hole. Comets kick it out, eventually out of bounds. And we've got a timeout on the floor. Timeout on the floor. Here in our second quarter tonight, as we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, is a night of giving here at the Missouri Comets. And members of the Comets team have some of their favorite charities in play tonight. We've already seen Byron Alvarez and the hundreds of soccer balls that were thrown on the field that he's taking down to Mexico City for kids there. Well, here in the second quarter, there's a live auction going on for Leo Gibson's charity, which is Kicks for Christ. And people are, they've got a silent auction going down there. They're bidding on jerseys, on soccer balls, on other types of memorabilia, and it all goes for a good cause. So once again, Leo Gibson and Kicks for Christ here tonight inside Independence Event Center.
It's not only big for the players in their charities involved, people within it, but the fans embrace it. And I saw Ellen Mayer come in with a bag of balls, and I go, what, did you get a new title? What's going on? And I go, what, are you signing autographs? You know, so he brought 4 or 5 balls in with Kenny, his son, and he just said, yeah, you're amazing. Don't even talk to me.
That's great. Yeah, again, we don't have we've got an active crowd tonight. Don't know how to say it. We certainly don't have the full complement that we would normally have on a Friday night here. We've got some weather in the Kansas City area, and that's prevented a lot of people from venturing out on the roads tonight. You and I are going to have to watch it going home. Here's a long pass for Brian Perez. Quiros raced back there with Brian. Now Vordberg will kick it along the boards, and Oliveira banged into Gibson. McKinney's up with it for the Wave. Over to Quiros, now forward for Bennett. Bennett tracks it down in the left wing corner, marked there by Sosa. Bennett away from the goal, back to Quiros. Quiros for 3, blocked by Perez. 2 other games in the MISL right now. St. Louis is leading Syracuse 7-4 in the third quarter. Syracuse, the other undefeated team in the league, by the way. And the Baltimore Blast are blanking Rochester 12-0 that game in the fourth.
One thing I think with St. Louis, I think they're going to get better as the year goes on, Nick. I mean, I think Darryl will always get structured, keep it disciplined, and he'll show a little bit more flair, and he's playing with a little, you know, less experience than some of the rosters here. So I think they'll get a lot better as the year goes on.
The Comets' 2 victories so far this season have come at the hands of the St. Louis Ambush. A 28-7 victory late in November, and then they returned to St. Louis where they eked out a 12-10 overtime victory. So the Comets' record stands at 2-1. And the Wave stand at a perfect 4-0. By the way, Milwaukee started the season with three straight road games. And they've just recently won their home opener against Baltimore 12-10. So Wave off to, yet again, another strong start. 6.5 to play in the first half, 5-0 Comets. Here's Alvarez. It's got some space. Byron trying to turn and the defender would get the ball from Liete, but Marcio gets it away. Comets seem to have gotten it back. Nope, still trading possessions here in Milwaukee's last third. Oliviero is there with a touch. Now Quiros comes near side for McKinney. Things have settled down. The Wave will press out. That one, a dangerous pass by Fontana. Vordberg had to kind of a 9-1-1 there to get it up towards the half line. Now back to Nick. He peanuts the ball out of bounds. It'll go to the Comets. And it will. It'll actually be at the top of the arc.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to move it there. But it's the game has changed a little bit, Nick, with the fans. The fans get to embrace a little bit more with that open glass. But a lot of those balls would never go off years ago. It's been in effect for 2 or 3 years, but before that, the ball would still be in play.
Yeah, and that's been the argument. Some coaches have voiced their opinion on it, and some of them don't like it with the glass down. You played in an era when the glass was up all around the field, and, you know, a coach would say that it promotes a more free-flowing game than what the game is like that right now with stoppages. What do you think?
Well, there's two different views, I would say, Nick. I mean, we'll talk about it after this one, but...
Here's Banks over to Liete, poked away by the Comets. Here's Megson, quickly out to Gibson. Leo tries to play it forward to Ossipor, but Milwaukee's defenders were back there. Excuse me, that was Tony Walls along with Ribeiro who got back for the Wave. Comets get it back. Robert Palmer simply irresistible on the far touchline. Back to the center circle and Brian Harris.
Dr. Marco up in the booth.
Doctor, good to see you, doctor.
Serving up some penicillin.
Oh, there was a drive by San Luis. How did he uncork that one?
Wow.
Banks comes up with a rebound for the Wave. Now Ribeiro forward to Liete. He's got some room. Marked by Harris now. Looking far post for Pereira. Comets knock it to the half line. Comets will be in action next weekend on Sunday afternoon. Comets will host the St. Louis Ambush for a 3:10 start coming up December 22nd. Again, that's next Sunday afternoon, 3:10. The Ambush and Comets renew their rivalry. Here's Banks front and center. Crossed in. To the middle, that one was off of Munoz. Now the ball back towards the referee's crease. Who comes up with it? Wave got it. Quiros forward to Everton. Marked by Harris. Harris quickly marked on Everton and just smothered him. Still fighting for it in the corner. Ramon Palmer is there along with Banks. Now Everton digs in. Here comes Pablo. Pablo gets a foot on the ball. And we'll play it back to the half line. Quiros will track it back and now all the way to Vorberg. There's Munoz over to Quiros. A couple of good additions for the Wave. Foul called on Missouri. Near side Pablo. Pablo to Everton. Back to Pablo. Shot ricocheted out into the right wing corner. Pablo goes for the volley. Waltman scoops it up. He's got it for the Comets.
Nick, Milwaukee's looking for a spark here. Anything, a foul, bad penalty, turnover in the, just losing possession. They're going to pressure. Notice the pressure's coming up. First quarter, they laid back a little bit. They're looking for a spark here, or they're looking for the Comets to self-destruct a little bit. So let's see what happens here in the next few minutes.
Here's Danny Waltman. And that one deflected back to Munoz with a drive for three, and that one just above the crossbar. Quiros plays it back in. Picked up there by Harris of the Comets. Plays it into open space, and now Brian Harris is shaken up.
Milwaukee foul, number 18, Carlos Munoz, his first.
Carlos Munoz, his first foul for the Wave. Harris is up on his feet. He's going to be all right.
He should be all right. 5 points in the first half. He got a little kick. He should get more than a kick. Send him a message. I'm like, leading scorer, you better get up, pal. You're a defender with 5 points in the first half. Jeez. I used to get kicked in the locker room if that ever happened. The one time in my career.
Under 2 minutes to play in the first half. And coming up at halftime, we have a scheduled guest. We're going to chat with Cal Williams, the voice of Sporting KC. And the MLS Cup trophy will make a visit here at Independence Event Center. There was Gibson with a drive. Gets it back. Goal, Comets!
What a great piece of work there and skill. Try and try again.
Would not be denied. Gibson gives the Comets a 7-0 lead. That's Leo's sixth goal on the year. He now has 18 points.
Look at in the booth, Greek. What a great move. Spins a little tippy-toppy, left-footed. Great block in front the first time. Comes right back to him, and he'll have none of that the second time. Thank you for shopping. Get your Christmas shopping done early.
Here's another view at it from Vordberg's angle. There's the first save.
The first angle was great for him. The second wasn't too good.
Threaded the needle on the second one.
Oh, right in there.
1:30 to play in the first half. Here comes Pereira. And Fontana will kick it deeper in Comet territory. Up with it there is Walls. Right side for Oliveira. Luan Salas Oliveira bangs it into the middle. LSO, as they affectionately call him in Milwaukee. Now Marcelo Fontana getting tangled up with Milan Ivanovic. Correction, Alex Megson. Megson cuts it back. Now back to the right.
Oh.
And front and center to Asad Poor. Left back for Sosa. Rolled it in. Vordberg makes the save. That one had some funky English on it. And Nick made a pretty nifty save there. Through the middle. And kicked away by Fontana. Stokic tried to play it back to Waltman, and Pereira almost got to it. Out of bounds, and the Comets will reset.
A little lucky there. Misfortunate backheader by Stefan, and just didn't get enough of it.
Did not get enough on it. Winds into the corner here, about 30 seconds to play in the first half. Out of play again, and it'll stay with Missouri.
Nick, the lady in the front row in the blue sweater,
yeah,
she's had some good touches on the ball tonight. She's hit the ball three times tonight in the first half.
Timeout on the field. And let's see here. Let's see what we got here. Oh, we can't. Keep hitting us with your thoughts on tonight's broadcast. What do you think about the Comets? Where are you watching from? Who's your favorite team in the MISL? Let us know about it. Send us a tweet at MISL Comets or at MISL. Use the hashtag if you're a Comets fan, beat the Wave, because I noticed Art Kramer, of course, who is the color analyst for Milwaukee, he didn't put hashtag beat the Wave there when he tweeted us.
Tell you a funny story, and if Art is still listening and watching, I was on the under 16 Gallagher, or Missouri select team. He was on the under 19 select team. Art, I apologize. You're a little older than me, more experienced. On the way back from the tournament, him and another gentleman, I think it was Gavain, they announced a 17 inning baseball game. Sound effects, the whole work, crack of the bat. And I'm like, man, that guy's going to be an announcer one day. Art, tweet us back if you remember that, because you did an unbelievable job. I was 16 years old, young boy from St. Louis, looking up to my veteran, Artie Kramer, and he announced a full baseball game.
Oh, my gosh.
And it was like click of the bat and everything. It was amazing.
Got to be a tape of that somewhere, doesn't there?
No, I don't think so. We don't. No recording devices on that trip.
There's a drive by Gibson. That one blocked by the Wave. Into the middle to Perez. Oh, it was deflected by his own teammate, Austin Poor, away from the goal. Gibson's got it back. 17 seconds left. Into Vahid. Now back to Leo. Bennett is there. Oh, Everton just took a swipe at Austin Poor.
That is bad.
I mean, Austin Poor on the ground, and Everton just kicked him with all of his might. Everton looks like he may have taken a shot.
No, but there's no reason to retaliate like that. Yeah, that's part of the game. And if referees don't sort this out,
they got to get control of this right now.
No call.
Okay, that was a foul.
A foul?
That was, yes.
He kicked him when he was on the ground, Greg.
That's been ruled a foul.
That's it?
That's it. I'm not. Everton's holding an area.
You know what I would do?
Ear.
I would go ahead hunting here. Just fire it high.
Here we go. Sosa. Off the wall. A drive. Ding dong off the post. Megson with a drive. 5 seconds left. Still pinballing around. That's going to do it.
Great first half, Greg.
Wow.
Honestly, they get a shutout. A lot of discipline, a lot of composure, and you know what? A ton of chances tonight for the Comets in the first half.
Two quarters are in the books. Coming up at halftime, we'll hear from Sporting KC's announcer, Cal Williams. We'll talk about to him about the experience this season and winning the MLS Cup. And then Jim and I will carry on in the third quarter. Thanks for watching the MISL. Comets lead it over the Waves, 7-0.
Comets fans, how you guys doing tonight? Make some noise, come on. I need you guys to do me a quick favor. Everybody needs to stand up right now. Everybody stand up, get out of your seats. You guys are gonna wanna be standing for this next thing. We have a special guest in the house. I want you guys to turn your attention right now to our goal, your MLS Cup. Sporting Kansas City, make some noise. Come on, Comets fans, let's hear you. Make some noise for Sporting Kansas City. I'm going to hand the microphone over to Cal Williams right here.
Steve, thank you. Good evening, Kansas City. My name is Callum Williams, I'm the voice of Sporting KC. First of all, I want to thank all of you for coming out here tonight. My first Comets experience, it's fantastic. I'll certainly be back here again. Just on behalf of Sporting KC, I just want to say thank you to each and every one of you here this evening, because without you, without a fan base, there is no Sporting KC, there are no Comets. It's the fan base that are the main part of a club. So thank you so much for all you've done. Without you guys, this isn't here. And just finally, guys, I want to say we can't wait for MLS 2014. So we'll see you all at Sporting Park next year. But for the time being, let's go Comets.
Let's hear it again for Sporting Kansas City and Cal Williams. Make some noise.
And we're back here at halftime, live inside Independence Event Center. Comets lead it over the Milwaukee Wave, 7-0. And if you've been with us here tonight, then you have just saw the presentation at halftime. Fans here tonight at the Independence Event Center got to see the MLS Cup trophy, of course, won by Sporting KC. And the voice of Sporting KC, Cal Williams, joins us now live. Cal, congratulations. It must have been a great experience from the beginning of the season all the way through the playoffs. You must treasure that whole time. It's really special.
MLS 2013 has been absolutely exceptional. It is most certainly a year that it's not going to be forgotten quickly. So, and you mentioned, obviously, we capped it off by winning MLS Cup 2013. And, you know, we all honestly thought that there was a chance we could make the playoffs again in 2013. But there were so many teams with so many strong rosters that I think if all of us were going to be realistic, we thought, okay, we can make the conference championship again and have a good year. But to win MLS Cup, I think we've exceeded expectations, and it's just wonderful. We all love an underdog, don't we? And it's turned out superbly.
It says a lot for the organization. The ownership, Kansas City, as a, you know, and Peter and the players, and you know what? The broadcasting crew. It takes a whole team effort. But to see it every time you walk in the stadium, being in Kansas City since 85, your hair stands up for where soccer's come and the ownership commitment, and to have them to have the ultimate payoff is, it's an amazing feat for soccer and the sporting owners and the whole organization.
Absolutely. You know, I was never a part of the organization when I heard about all the horror stories when nobody came to turn up and nobody came to watch games at Arrowhead and Community America Ballpark. And, you know, it was funny because I joined when they rebranded as Sporting, and still nobody really knew what Sporting was. It took a few months to get going, but that's because they played the first 10 games on the road. Once we got that out of the way, first of all, we rebranded, then we got the games out of the way, then we opened the stadium. The rebrand was complete. Everyone knew who Sporting was. There was something different to cheer for in Kansas City. And then we did something which a lot of teams in KC haven't done before, and we started winning. Then we won the Lamar Hunt US Open Cup, obviously fitting the trophy being named after our former owner. And then, as I said, this year, 2013, we went one better and won MLS Cup. So it's just been a steady progress, but it's been progress in the right way. And we're all so proud of the team and the whole ownership group, as you mentioned, the front office, the staff. It's been a wonderful few years. It really has.
The White Puma calls it a career. I thought I read something somewhere. Did he, in fact, have broken ribs when he was playing?
He did, yes.
In the championship match?
He did.
How did that happen?
I was told that it happened in a training game, but I'm not sure exactly when. But, I mean, it just shows how much of a character he's got, doesn't it, and how much he loves the game playing through. There was no way he was going to miss that game. Absolutely no chance. But it's a shame he's retired, but I think he will admit it was the right time to go. And what a perfect way to go as well. A perfect scenario, winning a championship, his second in his career, his first for 15 years, I think. So it was the right time to go. I think he'll admit that. And now it's over to Eric Kronberg and John Kempen, and we're looking forward to seeing the development those boys come up with.
Yeah, but you know what? Peter's on the road. He's traveling. He's in England. He's you know what? They don't rest too long there.
No.
You know what? The dust doesn't settle too much under their feet. As a coaching staff, as management, they're looking for the next best thing. They're talking about repeat. Okay, to win something like that is an accomplishment. They have the desire, they have the passion, and the ownership group and the whole organization behind them. Look for them to repeat. I mean, I would love to see it.
Hopefully. Well, we are very hopeful. You know, that there's absolutely no reason why we can't go and do it again, is there? So, you know, let's for the time being, let's enjoy the success, shall we?
And also here, as we wrap up our conversation with Cal Williams, I also think it's rather nice that the players from Sporting are supportive of the Comets, and the Comets, of course, are supportive of Sporting. I follow these guys on Twitter, so I see these guys. We've seen Sporting players show up here and support the Comets. It really is a nice relationship that the two teams
and
have.
Not only that, the Sporting guys are at FC Kansas City, the women's games. You see them 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 deep. Soccer's a passion. You know what? We all are involved in it.
Sure.
But former player, I see those guys, and they want to be part of it, and they are, and they're showing up to it and taking their time up. There's a lot of times that they have and they show up. It's a great testament for Kansas City Soccer.
We're all one big family, aren't we, when it comes to soccer in America? And with the way that it's exploded here in Kansas City, who wouldn't want to be a part of this family right now? It just keeps growing and growing and growing. Delighted to be a part of it.
All right, as we close it up, I think we need a group hug. Let me just get a group hug in here. Bring it in here, everybody. Oh, that's great. You couldn't see that. We really did do a group hug.
Nick's too touchy and feely. You know, on the newscast in the morning, you can't get away with that.
The voice of Sporting Kansas City, Cal Williams, here with the MLS Cup Trophy. Cal, thanks
Pleasure
a lot for
meeting
your time.
You, and yep, congratulations.
Thank you really very much, Jeff. Have a good broadcast.
Okay. Be careful out there on the roads, too, my friend. All right, we're just about ready to start the second half here.
Are you going back?
We've got the Comets in a huddle. We've got Milwaukee on the field warming up, and we've got the Missouri Comets with a 7-0 lead over the Milwaukee Wave. The Comets have shut the Wave out in the first half. That is a feat in itself. Comets trying to go to 3-1 on the season, and in the process, give Milwaukee its first loss on the year. Milwaukee 4-0 on the season. So in the center circle, we've got Milwaukee. It's Nicholas Pereira and Luan Salas Oliveira. And the second half is underway. Missouri wearing white. Comets in their blue, trimmed in red and white. Victor Quiroz forward to Nicholas Pereira. Pereira had it poked away from behind. Gibson got a touch on it. Up to Ossetpour. Back towards the Wave side. Try to slide it over to Leo. Broken up by the Wave. Leo gets it back. Fires. Blocked by the Wave. Rebound comes out towards the middle of the field. Harris is there. On back to Danny Waltman. Brian Harris responsible for two of the three goals. Harris has a three-pointer and a two-pointer for five on the night. He leads all scorers. Leo Gibson got the other goal for the Comets, and again, Milwaukee has been blanked in the first. Oh, the first few minutes. There's a volley. You better put that one in the Nelson Museum of Art. I'd pay money to see that one again. Lucas Rodriguez with a volley shot, and the Comets up 9-0 now.
Here we go, Greg.
Check this one out. You can hang a star on this one, Schwabe.
Oh, my God. I didn't know the circus is in town. The circus is in town in December.
Lucas Rodriguez for the Comets. That's Lucas. That's his second goal on the year. Comets out to a 9-0 lead. Leo Gibson the assist.
Hey, Greek, I think class act broadcaster for Sporting to come on, come up in the booth and spend some time. So I know time's valuable, and he's getting ready to go travel to Spain and all around the world and then come back. So he's going to re-energize and come back.
Cal Williams, a voice of Sporting KC. Yeah, it was good to chat with him. And also good to see that trophy. I guess the trophy itself is made of Tiffany's. Oh, Vordberg lost the handle. Get a drive and all. Oh, the Comets almost got it. Who was that? I think it was Alvarez, who nearly mugged Vordberg and then chipped it in. But Alvarez shaking up on the play. I'm wondering, hard to see there. Byron Alvarez on the turf here.
Well, I think the keeper got a piece of him. Obviously, but he didn't want him to score, so he had to get
Charlie Horse maybe or something.
No, that's just a good old-fashioned kick, Nick. I mean, you'd like to say Charlie Horse or a strain. No.
Yeah, you got kicked.
Or that's an embarrassment for not scoring. One of my former players, Jesse Jacobs, was up in the booth, and she's now rowing. She's on the rowing team at KU.
All right.
So she was up in the booth to say hello, so it was nice to see her.
Yeah, you're still actively coaching college?
Yeah, Johnson County. I think it's 25th, 26th year, but 15 with the women, and we had a great season this year, 17-3-1, and great
nice
group. And
congratulations.
It's still fun, Greek. It's still fun.
Here's Everton. Everton leaves it back for McKinney. Floats it over the top for Fontana. Down to the corner to Ian Bennett. Wall pass and almost knocked in. Brian Harris. Looks like Milwaukee wanted a handball there. Both teams play on. Fontana's got it. Fontana down to Everton. Front and center it comes to Ribeiro. Ribeiro runs into Gibson. Now we'll turn and back it up to Vordberg. Here's Ian Bennett. Forward to Everton. We pointed out in the first half that Everton has taken 10 shots this year. He's played in four games, but has yet to record a point, either a goal or an assist.
Quit talking like that, Greg. I'm telling you.
Here's Fontana looking for Oliviero, and that one took a funky hop off the top of the Dasher boards.
An old friend and a coach set the pace and control the tempo. Mr. Savick, congratulations, Zorn, on the championship. He used to tell that, used to echo that in your sleep when played for Zorn.
There's a drive, and that went up in the stands. Yeah, I was thinking about Zorn Savick, though. He's the former coach, former player for the Comets. You know, he's one of the few people. He's won championships as a player, as a coach, as a general manager, and now as
assistant
coach for Sporting KC in the MLS.
Indoor, outdoor GM. I mean,
man.
No wonder why I won't return my calls.
You on one as a player coach. Ryan Jung watching the game. Jung tweets in at me at MISL Comets, says Lucas 32 Soccer, which is Lucas Rodriguez Twitter handle. He says Lucas with a sick goal. My boys, MISL Comets doing work. Thank you, Ryan Jung, for watching tonight.
Ryan, I wish you all the best. You know what? Incredible player. Retired to go into business. I'm sure he's doing well for himself. Incredible work rate. And happy holidays to Ryan Jung.
I think I saw on there Brian Budzinski, who's part of the ownership group, say that the should make maybe SportsCenter's top 10. There's a drive by Milan, saved by Vordberg. Sosa gets it back. San Luis was trying to redirect. Now Cody Andrews steps across one person, big pileup. And Cody Andrews is going to need some roadside assistance here.
I hope he's not hurt. Since he's been in Harrisburg coming off the summer, a lot of confidence.
Here's
the
play.
He's a lot. Watch this tackle coming in.
It looks like he
that's
he
I
twisted
told you
the ankle a
it's
little
the
bit.
Season of giving. Giving a little pain there.
Here's Cody with a drive. Looks like Cody Andrews is all right. He's running a little bit light on that right ankle.
He's gingered a little bit, and that's what the ball goes up. I got to give him credit for that. I mean, he's got him a little discount for the tackle. But
Cody Andrews, local product from right here in KC.
The Harrisburg Islanders, a good friend of mine and former teammate, high school teammate Billy Betcher is the head coach there and GM.
I remember Bill Betcher.
From the Harrisburg.
Here's San Luis with some space. Moves to his right. His drive is blocked out of bounds.
Nick, he's hit the post twice tonight, created a lot of chances. If he scores, and I've said this before, he's coming off a major knee injury, playing with the brace. He looks good. He looks strong. If he scores, the Comets are going to be that much better. Not that game, but the confidence to go on through the season.
Comets lead 9-0. Restart in the right wing corner. Asadpour to Rodriguez. Blocked by the Wave. Everyone going for the rebound. Oliveira is there for the Wave. He turns, kicks it out, held in by Stokic. Poked away by Quiros of the Wave. Now Harris giving chase. He and Liete battle for it. Now Waltman advances it out towards the half line. trapped there by McKinney of the Wave.
Liete has been quiet. I think he's got to be injured a little bit. I know he's not on the list, but if you talk to Coach Tozier afterwards, from his behavior, he looks like he's hurting a little bit.
Emma Kohala writes in on Twitter and says, third quarter is getting more physical. I think you're right, Emma. Let us know what you think about the game on Twitter. Use the hashtag #BeatTheWave. Tweet us at MISL Comets or at MISL. We'll also get you an update to some scores around the league right now. Here's a restart coming up for the Wave. Marcio Liete to the left. Fabinho hits it first time, and that one up to section 119, almost to the concession stand.
Remember, every set piece makes somebody happy. That made him. Vlaco, happy. What a show that is, Greek. Duck Dynasty?
Yeah. Oh,
I mean, I'm mesmerized by that. By Fox 4 in the morning and Duck Dynasty, my two favorite shows.
I'm glad you get your priorities straight.
I'm sorry. I got to mention that one in a second.
Hey, Schwab, we got a couple of updates from two other games around the MISL tonight. In Syracuse, the St. Louis Ambush beat the Silver Knights 10-6 and send Syracuse to their first loss of the season.
Hey, congratulations to Darryl and the St. Louis boys, and it's a good way to start the holiday season.
Syracuse now 4-1.
There's our first penalty of the night.
Baltimore has shut out Rochester 12-0. Baltimore over Rochester 12-0. Here it is 9-0. Missouri Comets over the Milwaukee Wave. And the first penalty of the game is going to go to Ramon Palmer for tripping.
Remember, do not kick a sleeping lion. We talked about it.
This is how it happened last time.
The little things, the little penalties, all of a sudden power play goal. They all counted points. Greek. Okay, hopefully man down team can help.
Milwaukee has got their offense out there. Here's Ian Bennett. Back to Liete. Liete front and center. Down to Bennett. Drive save made by Walton. That one nearly stuck through, but he put his biscuits on it and stopped it from crossing the line.
I think he had the web between the legs there. I mean, he moves like a superhero. What about the web between the legs?
Here's Cody Andrews. Cody Andrews, Vahid Asadpour, Brian Harris, Leo Gibson. That's the man down team for the Comets. And there's Cody Andrews back out there fighting. Big pile up out there and a foul called against Milwaukee. And Oliveira's not happy about that.
Nick, you've been involved in a lot of games. Do you feel that Coach Tozier, the general, is a lot? He's quiet tonight. I mean, we haven't seen outbursts. We haven't seen him. I just think he's a little more quiet than normal.
Maybe he's patient. Oh. But you're right. Usually we can hear him from all the way up here. 9-0 our score. Waltman boots it out of bounds. We've got a response here on Twitter from Davin Lassiter, at Mr. Lassiter. He writes into at MISL Comets. He says, no dog in the fight, but the Comets are by far the most skilled team I've seen in the league. They are fun to watch. Thanks for weighing in, Davin. Thanks for watching. Here's Ian Bennett through the area, and Stokic clears it away. We don't know how much time is left. 43 seconds is left on the penalty. One of the scoreboards has been damaged by a racket up there. Here's Pereira with a drive. It comes off to Oliveira. Now Liete's got it left wing. 29 seconds left on the advantage. Liete over to Oliveira. Shot save made by Waltman. Pereira. Back to Liete. Liete looks at the clock, sees he's got 15 seconds on the power play. Left side, Pereira. One touch, back to Liete. Now moves to his left. left-footed drive, partially blocked by Harris. Down to the corner to Bennett, turns, fires, save made by Waltman. Ossetpour clears it away for the Comets, and they kill it off. Here's Ramon Palmer back into the game. Tries to cut it back to the left, down to the right, but is gobbled up by two white jerseys. One large one and Nicholas Pereira, who's a sizable man out there on the field. Ball squirts free. Ian Bennett is in the area.
I like the way you say that, squirts free. That is, oh, that is a different terminology in indoor soccer.
Harris to Gibson. Oh. Save made by Vornberg. How did he do that?
I thought he could squirt it through there, but he didn't.
7 minutes to go in the third.
My apologies to YouTube viewers.
We keep it on the family channel, but I don't think there's any rules.
No, honestly, great guy. It was all family. I'm just talking about.
I know.
That's good, great terminology.
I got to think twice here. I'm not sure if you're going for the double meaning or not.
No, not at all.
Pablo with a drive. Waltman kicks it into the Wave bench. And looks like they might spot that one at the arc when we return. Let's take a quick break. 6:36 left to play in the third. Comets 9, Wave nothing. Ah, yes. Comets fans. A lot of people have been writing in tonight, letting us know what they think about the game on Twitter tonight, at MISL Comets with the hashtag BeatTheWave. Presley Lewis says she's watching the Comets game on her phone. ... Oh, technology. Presley Lewis, thanks for watching the Comets. We appreciate it. Shelby Fran says, finally made the board. My night has been made. Let's get physical. Hashtag beat the wave. 6:36 to play. Here's Liete. Back to Olivero with a drive, and that one denied by the Comets. Olivero from Vordberg. Gibson comes up with a touch. Now here comes Gibson running like the wind. Crossed over to Megson. Megson cuts the defenders, still going forward. Vordberg is there and catches the bouncing ball.
You see the piece of skill with Leo. Everybody says that's a touch. That's a piece of skill. Little chili con queso sauce chipped it over the guy and kept running with it. Oh, my goodness. You dream about that stuff. Great touch.
Down to the corner to Everton. Oh, and Pablo tripped up. No penalty. Cody Andrews battling in the midfield. Bounces off to Vahid Ossetpour. Vahid will play it to Waltman. Comets will go for changes.
Greek, remember we talked about it. I talked about it maybe several times. The discipline that you need when you're in the lead. It's important that you don't spark it. Don't let Milwaukee come out of their shell a little bit. They're a skilled team. They're a veteran team. They have a lot of scorers on the team. And once they get momentum, watch them.
Here's Oliveira. Heads it over to McKinney on the volley, and that went up and over the glass.
So keep it going. Keep it. You have to go forward, but you have to keep the balance, and that's the key.
So far, so good. There's 5 minutes and 16 seconds left to play in the third, and the Comets are leading 9-0.
You know what makes me mad? Artie Kramer did not tweet back to say he confirmed the baseball
announcement. The baseball game on the 8-hour bus ride from
nine and a half hour bus ride. But who's counting? Entertainment, my friend. That's the last time he got paid for didn't get paid for entertaining.
Everton forward to Oliviero. Correction, that was Banks. Now McKinney gets tripped up along with Ivanovic, and a foul called on the Wave. That's Judson McKinney's first foul of the half. Danny Waltman looking for Milan Ivanovic. Also Alvarez in the area. Byron got tangled up with Tony Walls, and a foul called on Byron.
Byron's been quiet tonight.
Yeah.
23, we haven't called this number a lot. Hopefully we will coming in down the stretch here.
Alvarez has played in two games. He has one goal and one assist, a total of 3 points on the season so far. Byron did not play in the home opener when these two teams played here back November 16th. Alvarez touches it over to Perez. Brian Perez down the left flank. Now front and center to Sosa. Back to Perez. A drive. Kick save by Fordberg. And we've got a shaken up player at the other end of the field, and it's Judson McKinney. And McKinney is holding his left ankle right now. Larry Sales, who's been with the Waves since its inception, onto the field.
Larry's a class act. He's been around, and you know what? A guy comes down and he's not be able to walk off. He got it tweaked pretty good.
Getting some help off the field from trainer Larry Sales of the Milwaukee Wave. We'll see if Judson's able to come back.
And Larry's seen everything in this league. From the Canada borders, everywhere. He's traveled with Toge. I mean, he's part of the big team there in Milwaukee.
Well, it's one of the cool things about being a part of a team. I've had the opportunity to travel with you guys with the attack and, you know, with the trainer. I roomed with Franny, the trainer, for the Comets right now.
That's a bad job, though.
I'm tired.
Oh, gosh. That's not. Oh. You know why?
But you just
now you know how your wife feels. Now you know how Wendy feels. I mean, you had the sentence back then. Now she has the sentence. You know. Thank God you had Gus. Otherwise, she couldn't put up with both of you. I mean, she has that balance there. I'm getting in trouble.
I know you are. I know you are. But in 96-97, that was my first year with the club. And that's year you guys won the championship. And I was still learning a lot. And boy, let me tell you that I learned a lot. Nicholas Pereira nearly flicked it in over the head of Danny Waltman.
You didn't learn too much about broadcasting because you've always been great at that.
Well, thank you.
You learned about the road, the code of the road, conduct of the road. What a fun, you know what?
And but when you're winning, and what I think I learned is that when you win the championship, it's not about that night winning the championship. It's about training camp, and it's about traveling, and it's about a losing streak, and it's about a winning streak and coming back, and it's about a player stepping up. All that's taken place over the course of an entire season. You really cherish the 4, 5, 6 months that you spend with a team there with everybody working for a common goal.
You know what? It's the periods, crossing the T's, dotting the I's. It's all about, it's a flow of the game. It's evolution. Whatever that happens in the season, and people that have been part of a championship, it's even, I mean, Greek, you've been part of, everybody has. And it's special.
Oh, what was that? How did that go in? That was Carlos Munoz, and that one had some funky spin on it. It looked like it may have deflected off Stokic. Let's take a look at the replay here.
It did. It deflected off him here.
And look at Munoz.
He just tries
to... Oh, how did he... Man, he just kicked it off Stokic, and it goes in for three. Well, and it's 9-3.
The backspin and everything off Stokic. You know what? Danny Waltman couldn't do anything about it.
Oh, that was incredible. That one had some dip on it, too. So the Wave on the board for the first time tonight. 2:18 left to play in the third. Long way to go, friends. 9-3, Comets lead. Perez with a drive from three. Vordberg's got it, throws it long for Oliveira. Waltman way off his line. He hits it to the referee's crease. San Luis is there. Stefan San Luis, a lot bigger than you might think he is.
That's not a welcome challenge on a 50-50. Anytime he's involved, it's a 70-30. Yes.
There's Victor Quiroz. Now Perez back to Sosa. And it comes to Ramon Palmer back to Sosa. Now Robert Palmer back to Sosa. Sosa cuts it into the right. Cross through the area to San Luis. Good move by San Luis. Back to Perez. His drive blocked by the Wave. Giuliano Oliveira to Luan Oliveira. Now to Victor Quiroz. And forward, and here come the Wave. Here comes Tony Walls. Cross pass over to Oliveira. LSO with a move to his left. Another one to his left and fires it over the glass.
I like to see the responsibility of Palmer there defending that. Before, they gave him room and gave him room to be creative. Tonight, they're closing him down a little bit.
9-3 our score. 1 minute, about 1 minute to play in the third. Banks there gets knocked down by the Comets' Brian Harris. Brian with his first foul here in the second half. Comets are 2-1 on the season. Milwaukee is 4-0. Again, the Wave started the season with three straight games on the road. Last week, they beat Baltimore in their home opener 12-10. Here's a drive by, that one was by Banks, and that one deflected wide. Milwaukee hangs on to the rebound. In the middle, it comes to Pereira. Kicked away there by Cody Andrews, the KC kid. Vordberg off his line up to Pablo. Now Ribeiro. And Marcio Liete, marked by Asitpour. Liete goes by him on the right. Right footer crossed into the middle, deflects to Pereira. Pereira moves to his left. That one blocked by Megson. Megson up to Gibson. And Gibson knocked down by Pereira. Foul called on Milwaukee. 6.2 seconds left in the third. Low scoring game in contrast to what we saw here back in middle November. Horn sounds, and that's going to do it for the third. We'll take a break. Missouri Comets 9, Milwaukee Wave 3, fourth and final frame are coming up. Thanks for watching the Major Indoor Soccer League.
helping us out real fast. Come on. All right, Ashley, what we're going to do is we have an opportunity for you to win some concert tickets thanks to our friends at Mix 93.3. So what we're going to do is name that tune. We're going to play three song hooks, and you've got to tell me what those songs are. Are you ready for that? All right, let's drop song number one when you're ready. All right, what was that song? What does the fox say? There you go. All right. There's one goal shot. Song number two. All right. What is this song?
Get Lucky.
Get Lucky. There we go. All right. Our last one. Here we go. Hit it. What's this one?
Oh, my God.
Here we go. Hurry. Maroon 5, Love Somebody. All right, here's what we're going to do. You're going to get two shots real quick on goal. If you make one, you get Miley Cyrus tickets. Here we go. Go for it. Give it a kick. One more shot. Come on, give me it. Right over here. Give it a kick for Miley Cyrus tickets. Come on. You know what? We're still going to hook you up with some tickets. How about that? Congratulations for Ashley for helping us out. Ed, back to you.
Fourth quarter is underway, and Asad Poor there with a drive from three. Comets lead 9-3. Here's Pablo to Carlos Munoz, who got the wave on the board in the third quarter with a three-pointer. Back to Everton. Now Marcio Liete, marked by Asad Poor. Liete dives in. Now Everton with a touch. Pablo. Right side, here's a drive by Kiros, and that one over the glass. Tonight's attendance, 3,569. The Missouri Comets say thank you.
Listen, Nick, 3,500 here, disappointing. But with this weather, you forecasted it. You did the traffic all day at your regular job. What an amazing attendance for the weather we have here.
Let me tell you, those of you that might be listening in some other part of the country other than Kansas City, we had ice this morning, and it caught a lot of people off guard. People were falling down when they walked out to get their papers, not to mention what it was doing to the roads and trying to drive on that stuff. Long pass by Voidberg for Oliviero. Heads it back for Walls. Walls with a volley! Shazam! Another three-pointer for the Wave, and it's now 9-6.
Nick, remember I was telling you about numbers in transition? 3-v-2, three-pointer. You cannot get caught in transition here, especially when you're in the lead.
Three-point goal for number 15, Tony Walls, with the assist to number 21, Giuliano Oliviero. Number 15, Walls, number 21, Oliviero, 3 points at 137.
Oh, what a drive by Walls.
He hammered it. He hit it all.
Yes, he did.
that's a
heavy ball right there.
Oh, and it was a little dipper.
Huh.
intensity now. Look at Milwaukee picking it up. Here we go.
Oh. Drive by Stokic up and over the glass. Goal kick coming up to Milwaukee. The Comets have outshot the Wave 29-16 so far.
How about Alex Megson's move over there? He could, oh my goodness, he carved him up in a phone booth over there. Cut him. You know what his dad, Neil Megson, must be proud. I hope you're watching, Neil. All the best. Happy holidays.
Judson McKinney is back in there after getting shaken up in the third quarter. That ankle must be all right. Tony Walls gets his first goal of the season, and a big one, a three-pointer. 9-6 is our score. Ribeiro to Banks. Now McKinney for three. The good doctor.
Delivering as always.
Ian Bennett over there with Ivanovic. Now Gibson's got a chance, but racing back there is Banks. Good, a good defensive play by the Milwaukee defender. Now Ribeiro. Up to Oliviero. Heads it over to Bennett. Waltman way off his line, clears it away. Now Ossetpour. Here's Vahid with space to Gibson. Oh! You can hang a star on that one, baby. Comets goal, 11-6.
Nick, what a ball in transition on the break by Vahid. And then you think he's going to settle it? No, a little flick to the back post. Oh, my goodness.
Watch this.
This is vintage indoor soccer. Look, I
just redirected it. Leo Gibson, his second on the night. It gives the Comets an 11-6 lead.
From up here, he looked like he caught it off the corner of his eyes. Keeper leaned a little bit, and he flicked it to the back post.
Good look at it right here.
Oh,
there it is.
My goodness.
Just flicked
it. That is dirty sick. Dirty sick. Nasty. Oh.
Leo now has 7 goals on the year. And here comes Cody Andrews with some space. Cody over to Ramon Palmer. Comets goal. Andrews to Ramon. And the Comets are up 13-6.
Addicted to love. But Cody Andrews cut the ball out and cut out, I mean, and beat a guy, carved him up, and then served. You don't get service at Plaza 3 there. I know they're not our sponsor, but they might be.
I'd buy a ticket to see that again.
You would? Let's see it again then. You're going to buy a ticket. There you go. Oh, money in the bank. I would like for you to get the dust out of your wallet. Let me see the replay. Look at that. Oh, the dust is flying out of Mr. Vasso's Fox 4 money here. Here we go.
You know what? I don't have it with me right now.
No, I understand. I've heard that one. I've heard that for 20 years.
That's why I love you.
One thing you are, consistent in performance and consistent in behavior. That's why I love you.
Wave trying to win it back on the half line. Megson got tangled up with Munoz, and Alex called for the foul. 11 minutes to play. 13-6 after the Wave trimmed it to 3. Here's Marcio Liete. Into the... Oh, Munoz of Waltman makes a 6 save. No. I can't believe he kept it out.
Oh, my goodness. There is no... You folks on YouTube, there is no way he stole that. The scoreboard was on. He grabbed it. Oh, my goodness.
If we can see a replay of that, that's the save of the night so far.
To be honest with you, Nick, I don't even know if they could see it on replay. It was that quick.
Oh, here it comes. Munoz. Oh,
look at this.
Through the middle.
Oh, he thinks he has a goal.
Oh.
Take the gift out of my stocking.
Wow, what a save by Waltman. Waltman up to Rodriguez. Boy, the Wave with some high pressure here. McKinney. McKinney goes down again. And a foul called on Stokic. And I wonder if McKinney tweaked that same ankle again. No.
That he's usually what happens, Nick. It never happens to your good ankle. It's always the sore one. And it usually happens for, 20 to 40 games a year.
Valerie Ratterman says on MISL Comets, just keep playing that song, Baby I Like It. Another save is made by Waltman. Here's Oliveira through the area. Marcelo Fontana tracks it down with Rodriguez. Pinball's out front and center. Both Alvarez goes down. McKinney's there and... Alvarez doesn't want any help getting up. Not from Tony Walls or Luan Oliveira. It'll be Milwaukee's ball. Here's Oliveira behind it. Fires one from long range, and that one deflected wide. Ossetpour lifts it towards the center circle. Oliveira will head it back to Vordberg. He distributes out to McKinney. Judson McKinney, forward to Oliveira, and then headed back into Waltman, who distributes out to Alvarez. Byron settles it, sends it out wide. Here's a drive by Robert Palmer. He found that shot simply irresistible.
You couldn't resist. You know what? I get up in the booth here and I go, all the coaches in the past, the Tozers, Zorns, Dave Clemens, everybody, and all the people that you talk to, watch your shift changes. Make sure you have good changes. Keep your shift short, I should say. And that's the key right now is play with discipline. Don't try to do anything out of your outer body. Just keep it consistent, and that's what's going to win games.
Comets lead by 7. Long way to go. 9:20 left on the clock here in the game. Here's Everett. No, correction. That was Banks with a drive there on the volley. And it goes out of bounds. Nine minutes to play in the fourth. Cody Andrews is there. On back to Sosa. Leanne Robinson writes in on Twitter, at MISL Comets. She says, MISL Comets game, Danny Waltman is keeping this team on top. Leanne Robinson, I couldn't agree more. Tell us what you think. Let us know on Twitter, at MISL Comets. Use the hashtag Beat the Wave.
Leanne works out at Mr. Moody's place and Athletes Fit. She works very hard in the off season. And Leanne, enjoy your vacation in San Diego. Well deserved.
FCKC.
And she's one of the most dynamic players, two-way players in the league, and she's always working out. So Scott Moody's always keeping the girls fit and the guys. So,
and thanks for watching, Leanne.
I think she's here. Guarantee you she's in the building.
She's here? Was she watching it on her phone?
She's in the building.
Leanne, tweet us back. Let us know if you're in the building. You don't have to tell us where you are, but are you in the building? 8 minutes left to play in the game. Comets 13, Wave 6. Alex Megson into the corner. And Banks gives chase. Megson digs it out. Boy, he's got an aggressive game going tonight,
doesn't
he? I'll
tell you what, Megson, every time he's on the field, Nick, 77 makes things happen.
Ossetpour, team captain and assistant coach, on back to Danny Waltman. Danny has had a terrific game tonight. Up to Rodriguez. High pressure from the Wave. Foul called on Milwaukee.
You know what? I'd like, he has played terrific, and he's also distributed terrific. Quit taking the chances late in the game. Space is the key here, and when you give it up in that space, it's trouble. Let's not take chances. I know confidence is one thing. We just got to be convinced tonight.
We'll see how they do here. We're getting to that time, Coach. Coming up on 7 minutes to play. 7-point lead by the Comets. Now over to Ossetpour with some space to Gibson. Oh, it was blocked off the line by Banks. Unbelievable block there by Banks of the Wave.
You could show that 1,000 times and it wouldn't happen. It would not happen.
Oh, my.
Banks put the head out and saved it.
J.C. Banks just saved his keeper's bacon. Look at that right there. Great shot of it, guys, down there in goal.
But very unselfish of the boys, Fahid and Leo, look at knocking it. All of a sudden, he knocks it to the back post, and he, you know, what, he thinks it's a goal, and he heads it out.
Timeout called by Milwaukee.
Why use your hands, Nick, when you can just use your head? Don't we tell our boys that at home?
Yes.
Come on. Don't be physical. Use your head.
J.C. Banks with 2 goals and 5 points on the season. He's got a game-winning goal and a 3-point goal in 4 games for Keith Tozier's Milwaukee Wave.
Hey, before it gets too late in the game and we forget about it and we run out of time, I want to wish Milwaukee fans, MISL fans, Kansas City fans, you and your family, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, be safe. It's been a great ride. I'm saying just enjoy yourself, enjoy your family, and the happy times.
Jim, thank you.
You're welcome.
Same to you and your family.
You're welcome, buddy.
We wish the best for you guys. Ah, look at this here. 6:51 left to play. And as we look at the fans here dancing in the stands, there's going to be some changes on the field.
Well, 6 attacker came out last time pretty early. Well, you know what? I think it's a little bit later than last time. But Toge knows the momentum has been Kansas City. He needs to change something here. He's going to take a chance, and let's see what happens. If they score, they're in it. If they don't, they can score big, though. They have some big-time late. They have some big-time players that can hit the ball.
All we got to do is go back to November 16th. Comets led by 6. And the Wave closed in to tie it in the final minute. They've been the comeback kids all year. Can they do it again? Oliveira to Liete right side. Munoz front and center. Quiros now left side. Oliveira, 6th attacker on for the Wave. Marcio Lete, Quiros into the middle to Pereira. Now to Ian Bennett, don't let him get the ball. That one off the glass and comes to Ossetpour. Vahid lost it, Milwaukee controls.
Keep the ball in front of you, don't let the ball go down the corners. I'm sure they've watched this film from last time, maybe over. you would like to throw this film away.
No kidding.
60, 70 times.
Marcio Liete, right wing, going against Ossetpour. Deflected away, and Harris! Oh, ding-dong off the post. Nearly got a three-pointer from his own side of the field.
Nick, and I apologize, you guys don't see us up in the booth. I probably hit the cashmere sweater. My hand's going to have cashmere on it all day. I apologize, Nick, for hitting you so much tonight.
Here's Bennett in the corner. Back to Oliveira. Near side, Liete, marked by Ossetpour of the Comets. Liete moves to his right. Ossetpour denies him. Now front and center, Quiros. Into Oliveira. Left side, Oliveira. His drive blocked out of bounds by Harris.
You see Liete off the screen here, but Liete wants more movement from the down, the players down in the post. Meaning in the corners, he wants more movement. When he looks one way, he wants them to cut in. They're not cutting in. Lack of movement is causing lack of creativity right now.
13-6, Comets lean over the Wave. Here's Luan Salas Oliveira, LSO. Into the corner, to Banks, a drive save made by Danny Waltman. I think that was Heverton who got the shot there.
Deflected out of play.
Nick, one thing that we've seen, last time they created it as we face the television, left hand, the right-hand corner as the defense is looking at Danny Waltman's right side. All the creativity was on the right side in the corner. They need to cut that out. They cut it out for early. Every time they get a good chance, it goes to the right-hand corner. Danny Waltman's right hand. Sorry.
Gotcha. In the left wing corner, they've got Marcio Liete on the ball. Liete up to Munoz. A drive, rebound by Everton. Still out, still pinballing around. And deflected wide. We've got a whistle. And what's going on here? A foul?
No, Everton kicked Leo in the head on the volley. And you know what? Thank goodness he hit his head instead of the ball. His streak is still alive.
Everton scoreless so far this season in four games, which is a bit surprising, as we noted earlier.
That's amazing with the skill and the creativity that he has and the physical ability. That won't last long.
4 minutes and 40 seconds left to play. Waltman throws it long, chested by Gibson.
Gibson. Notice, Nick, they're not taking chances now. I mean, I would like to take them more I would like for them to take more chances, but they're, you know, the message is organization, discipline right now.
Robert Palmer's in there. Here's Palmer over to Harris. Harris tried to cut it back. Everton and Oliveira collapse on him. Harris gets it near side. Ossetpour is there. Comets will play it back to Danny Waltman and almost right to Munoz.
Yeah. Whoa. I think after Vahid kicked it, he was like, oh, my.
Here's
goodness.
Cody with some space. Over to Robert, to Harris.
No.
Comets goal.
Can you say
Cody Andrews?
Cody Andrews to Harris. And Brian Harris, the hat trick tonight.
I'll have to say, if Cody Andrews was getting tipped tonight, he'd have a lot of tips. Because he might not be getting the, I mean, he's getting an assist, but he set up so many people tonight.
That is Brian's ninth point on the night. Three goals, one three-pointer, and two twos. Wow. 7 points.
Yeah,
yeah, that's what I meant. I said seven. I said seven.
That's okay.
Nine.
Nine and seven, same difference.
Good businessman like yourself caught that right away, didn't you?
Oh, you know, hey, I just had to check it out. Like, oh, man.
Well, it's looking better right now. 3:45, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. There's still time left. Quiros. Harris's goal there bought the Comets some extra insurance, if you know what I mean. Now Liete off the glass, flies in front of the goal mouth over to Oliveira. Down to Bennett. Bennett with an impossible angle. That one through the area.
Let me tell you something. Danny Waltman has come up big 10 to 12 times tonight on foot saves, great saves. Unbelievable.
And Waltman's got it.
Look for a timeout here.
You called it. Timeout by the Comets. Well, reminder that the Comets' next home game is coming up on Sunday when they will host the St. Louis Ambush, and it's a 5:10 kickoff. 5:10 kickoff against the St. Louis Ambush.
And I remember this. We're in Milwaukee. We played a game in St. Louis, Wichita, and Milwaukee. Three games in 3 days. And you're probably announcing the game. They're up 19-6. Two something left, whatever. And one of their players, our Victor Noguera, probably the best all-time geek, calls a timeout. As a coach or a player, I'm sitting there like this. I go, what the hell are you doing calling a timeout? You know, it's been an extra 20 minutes at a funeral. No disrespect. I said, so the next play, I go, okay. I walk by the bench. soon as the ball came out, I kicked somebody as hard as I could. That's enough of that. Don't disrespect. This is the long enough agony. It's not out of, I mean, this game was out of hand in Milwaukee. We'll see what happens here because somebody said something to Danny coming to the bench. And I'll guarantee I was one of those guys would say something.
Interesting.
Yeah, but that's a little thing so you don't pick up on. Yeah, I mean, I whacked a guy waist high. I apologize. Talk to your captain or talk to your coach.
Blame him. Ric Flair.
Oh, the nature.
Nature boy.
Here we go. But he called timeout. You know what? To organize it, but 15-6. Is it over?
It's almost.
Oh, we got the big lady ready to sing. We got the big lady ready to sing.
We're ready to roll up the sidewalks, baby.
Silent night.
2:38. Comets lead at 15-6. Here comes Tony Walls. He runs into Gibson. Comes off to Pablo. Left side, Judson McKinney. Now Pablo center circle. Victor Quiros is there. Now Oliveira down to Bennett.
For 3,500 people, Nick, they've enjoyed a good show for the Comets.
And this is a good win for the Comets. Oliveira with a drive.
MVP right there, Mr. Yellow Shoes, Mr. Harris.
Here, lost it now. Liete with a drive, and Waltman rises up like a fish out of the water to swat that one away.
That's the only mistake Brian Harris has made tonight. Don't let the ball get cut out in the middle of the park. I said it to my kids, college kids, you do not make mistakes late in the game in the middle of the park. It's Transition City. It's the superhighway. It's the Euro highway. There's no speed limit there.
Here's Liete to Everton. Oh, hit the post. Goodness. Ding dong. Everton just cringes as he looks up at the lights at the Independence Event Center. 1:36. Comets are going to win. They're going to move to 3-1, and the Wave are going to fall to 4-1. So there are no more undefeated teams left in the MISL. There's a shot at Waltman ranging to his right, boots it, and plays at the length of the field.
Remember last game, Nick, Danny Waltman, crucial time in the game, threw a ball that he tried to score, and they cut it out.
Yep.
You know what? A lot of people, I mean, not a lot of people, but I cringed on that because he could have held on to it, threw it in the corner, whatever, and it turned around transition. They scored. And he's learned. I mean, listen, he's matured a lot. This is the best professional game I've seen, complete game. Maybe not the acrobatic saves, but the most. This is a good sign for the Comets. If I was Santa Claus and I was the coach,
yeah,
I would love this present tonight. I would love it. I mean, yeah, oh, I'd be like, oh, Mrs. Claus, here we go. Look at us.
Everton making a bid for his first goal on the season. A little bit off the mark once again. He's been close, but hasn't been able to tickle the twine, so to speak. Under 30 seconds to play.
But do you see another? Do you see more patience from Danny?
No doubt about it.
You see composure.
Good decisions.
A little more calmness.
Danny got dumped there on the carpet.
As soon as I say that, he does that. Oh, my goodness. I should shut up. Sorry.
Foul against Milwaukee. 8 seconds left. Comets with an impressive performance here tonight. 8.9 seconds left. And they'll hold it for the end. That's going to do it. Comets now a 3-game winning streak. They beat the Milwaukee Wave at home at the Independence Event Center. Final score, the Missouri Comets 15 and the Milwaukee Wave 6.
Fran broke out in a sprint.
That's not a sprint.
Hey, Greek, I've had fun. Jeff, first class as always. Thank you.
And once again, the Comets, after a win here today, led by Brian Harris and his hat trick, Brian scored 7 points on the night. Comets will be in action next weekend on Sunday evening at 5:10 when the Comets host the St. Louis Ambush. We'll have the game for you right here, and you can get your tickets at cometsindoorsoccer.com.
15-6, Comets win. Brian Harris, star of the game. Byron Harris, you know what? He played his factor, but he wasn't the star. But the problem, I mean, I see the good thing here, Greek. Discipline. More discipline. They're paying attention to detail, and it's success tonight. Congratulations to the Comets.
Congratulations. We look at some of the some of the highlights. For the Milwaukee Wave, they're going to have some time off. Their next game will be a two-game homestand at the end of December on the 28th when they will host the St. Louis Ambush at 6 o'clock and on December 31st against the Syracuse Silver Knights. That's a 2 o'clock afternoon game at the Cell. That's going to do it for our broadcast here live at Independence Event Center. Yeah. For my broadcast partner Jim Schwab and the entire Missouri Comets staff, we thank you for watching. Once again, the final score, the Comets 15 and the Wave 6. You've been watching the Major Indoor Soccer League.
Yes, I am. All right, look at my shirt.